Coqui frogs, little fire ants, coconut rhinoceros beetles, just some of the invasive species in Hawaii that can do a lot of damage to our ecosystem. But the last line of defense to stop pests at the airport could leave us vulnerable. Gina Mangieri is always investigating and went searching on what can be done to reduce the risk.
If you travel in and out of Hawaii a lot, by now, this is old hat. Before you go, scan your bags at agriculture before you check them in. It's been like that for a long time.
I started in 81, and we had counters all in front of the airlines and opened baggage. Actually opened the baggage, went through it. I'm glad we don't do that anymore.
On the way into Hawaii, though, there's a piece of paper declaration form and an amnesty bin.
The whole honor system, people might be bringing stuff in, and you won't be able to know because it's just a piece of paper.
It's not very thorough at all because I could have had anything in my bag. And unless it was a weapon or something, they're not going to care.
The ag form has been around in one form or another for a really long time. Here's the declaration when the first men on the moon passed through Honolulu. People follow the rules in varying degrees.
But I'll tell you this, people don't fill out the form. Because even I, who go first class, I don't fill out the form if I'm sleepy. I don't fill out the form, right? All I do is just go in there, I say, okay, I'm with this person.
Do you always fill out that form on the airplane?
Yes. I think every passenger does.
Do you think it's enough, though, to prevent all the things from sneaking through?
No, I guess it's not.
Why?
Oh, it's only a form, and so I guess they got to tighten the inspection downstairs, I guess.
On the way back, piece of paper and a box. Why the difference?
The difference is a difference between federal and state mandates.
Feds with the USDA are on the lookout for specific things like bad Hawaii fruit flies they don't want on the mainland. Hawaii's is more of a catch-all system.
Are they always collected, though, and what do you do with them?
Unfortunately, we don't. With our staffing changes and due to the reduction in forces a few years back, we don't have a night shift anymore at the airport. We're not able to meet off flights. We do screen everything. We do examine everything. But if there's something suspicious, you know, after the fact, it's a lot harder to do.
Why not have an actual scanner coming the other way?
In a perfect world, you know, if I could ask the federal government, yes, I would. I would like it.
It's really good to go through the bags and see, you know, pick out the bags that have something of agricultural interest.
The federal scanning system intercepts thousands of things a month. The state paper had no confessions of anything illegal in about the same amount of time, yet they still say it's helping.
What do you want to say to the folks who kind of brush it off?
Well, that it's important. It really is important. It's a pain in the butt, you know. My main problem is I like to travel light. I don't have a pen. So, but that's a good opportunity to make friends with the person next to you.
As for those honor box amnesty bins.
The amnesty bin is hit or miss.
What's usually in there?
Rubbish. But, you know, there's always some fruits or vegetables. And historically, we've had things like we've had a snake in there before.
The state wants a biosecurity facility at the airport where they can work side by side with the feds on closer incoming inspections. But besides money hurdles, there's major red tape in the agriculture laws themselves.
If a federal inspector finds something that's of concern to Hawaii, if they can let us know right away, then that would actually be the most tangible and direct form of assistance that the federal government can give us.
How long is it taking now?
They're not really allowed to share that information. Federal inspectors have gotten in trouble and have had lawsuits filed against them.
They've gone to Hawaii's congressional delegation with their concerns over the years. Senator Brian Schatz told KHON2 he's in touch with both sides on cutting the bureaucratic red tape. Meanwhile, State Ag tells us they'll focus on a streamlined pest list alongside the USDA. Electronic manifests for air cargo like the ocean shippers have, also a strategic plan. As for new ways to tackle that pesky form.
If everyone's seat on an aircraft had something that could then collect the data and be transmitted to the department, that would actually work really well. But we're not quite there yet.
Is it something you're looking at?
I just thought of it.
Gina Mangieri, KHON2 News.